Hi, you guys. I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing, and today I want to tell you what I think about FAANG stocks. Before we get started, make sure you click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notifications when I release new videos. So, over the past couple of years, the term FAANG stocks has become one of the most commonly used terms in investing circles, FAANG. However, what companies does FAANG refer to, and why are these things so popular? So let's take a look at everything you need to know about FAANG stocks before you invest in one of the FAANG companies. So FAANG, this is an acronym referring to the five largest tech giants on the market today. The five companies that make up the FAANG, by the way, it's spelled F-A-A-N-G, are Facebook, Apple, Amazon, Netflix, and Google. So these are all amazing companies. We all are using them, I'm sure. So while there's certainly other publicly traded tech companies out there, these five stand out in the crowd because they're gigantic in terms of their size, but they're also huge growers. They've been able to achieve unbelievable growth over the last few years, and that growth has made them an incredibly popular investment and has made them a major topic of conversation on every investing website and TV channel and every media outlet. The popularity of these stocks is multifaceted. For one thing, the FAANG stocks are so popular because of an ever-increasing significance of the technological revolution. I mean, over the past couple of decades, technology has rapidly changed just about every aspect of the world, from the way people interact, to the way they work, to the way they entertain themselves and beyond. And believe me, it really has impacted my world probably more than anything I can think of. I think, in fact, the advent of these kinds of technologies on the investing world is what has democratized the investing of money. It used to be, before these technologies were developed, that we were like, you and me, were like just illiterate people back in the 1400s before the invention of the printing press. And then along comes the printing press, suddenly literacy becomes possible for just the ordinary person. And all of a sudden the world changes, all kinds of changes happen to the way that we get governed because of the democratization of literacy. And I would say the democratization, if I can say that word, the democratization of financial literacy has come about now for many people because of the advent of these FAANG type companies. So they're really changing the world and really making it possible for me to talk to you about going out and investing your own money. So together, these guys, these five companies, are leading the charge when it comes to changing the world through technology, absolutely. And they are seen now as major disruptors that are gonna be increasingly important as time goes along. At least that's how you could look at it. But the popularity of these products that these companies are putting out, this is also a big part of their attractiveness to investors, for sure. And that means from the iPhone to Facebook account to a Google browser, the products that these companies produce are used by the majority of people in the industrialized world. And lastly, most important, the popularity of the FAANG stocks among investors is stemming from the growth that they've been able to produce, right? And that drags in investors. And there's no denying that each of these five companies has been able to grow their revenue and market share, cash flow, at an astounding rate. And that has given investors like me some incredible returns over the last few years. Now, I haven't invested in all five of these things, but I have invested in Google, and I've invested in Apple, and I've taken a hard look at Facebook, but I haven't invested in Netflix or Amazon. And I'm thinking that there's gonna be a time when I'm gonna be taking my money out of an Apple and a Google here. The most important consideration that we have once we've decided we wanna own a company is its price. We wanna buy it at a great price. The popularity of these stocks with investors is so intense that you really could make a case that, you know, maybe these companies are getting too pricey to invest in. If you are thinking about investing in these stocks, just remember this: no matter how popular a stock gets, it's really essential to evaluate it using the same standards we use for any other company. As Rule One investors, we're going to use the four M's to determine whether or not this stock's worth investing in, meaning moat, management, margin of safety. three most important words of investing: margin of safety. And I've actually got a really great PDF on my website that explains these four M's really well. So click the link on the screen to get to that. So how do the FAANG stocks hold up on the four M's, right? Well, let's talk about that. Does the stock have meaning to me? Now, this is me, right? When Warren Buffett was told by Bill Gates he should be investing in tech companies like this years ago, Buffett said, look, I'd rather invest in chewing gum. But more recently, Buffett has continued to change his investing strategies as he goes forward, which he's done his whole career. And now he's investing in at least one of the FAANG stocks. So does it have meaning to a guy like Buffett? Because it's got to. He's got to understand the business, and it has to be the same thing for you. You've got to understand the company. You've got to believe in its mission. You got to understand its values. And those things are critically important. That given the influence that the FAANG companies have in the day-to-day lives of most people, understanding how these companies operate in the world starts to come pretty easy, right? We all kind of understand what they do. Now, the next thing is a little harder. Is there a moat? So most of the FAANG stocks really have strong moats, right? Apple has this ecosystem that it lives in. Google, my gosh, it is virtually a toll bridge if you want to do search. And no smartphone is going to surpass the popularity of the iPhone, right? No new e-commerce stores likely to draw away Amazon customers. So these are gigantic moats. Now here's the catch. The moat exists today, but many of these companies live and die on what's called creative destruction. And if you are owning a company that has to destroy its previous iterations, right? iPhone 10 has to wipe out iPhone 8, then you really have to be careful about understanding the moat of that business. If Apple didn't have such a strong ecosystem, I probably wouldn't invest in it because I don't like putting my money in something where I can't predict the next 5 to 10 years with some pretty high degree of certainty. So it's really important to keep in mind that technology does change rapidly and the moat of a company, even like a Google, could be overestimated. Who knows really for sure what kind of search engine we're going to be using in 10 years, likely something from Google, but not nearly this kind of confidence that we can have in it of, let's say, are we going to be chewing gum the same way in 10 years? Now, the next piece is also really important. What does the management of the company look like? The CEOs of these FAANG companies, guys like Tim Cook, Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg, these are some of the most well-known and important CEOs in the whole world. And constantly being in the public spotlight probably encourages this to have a pretty high degree of honesty and integrity. And I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed by what all of these people are doing and how they're responding to the pressures coming at them by being so large. Leading these companies to the level of success that they have achieved is really demonstrates they have incredible management ability. And I mean, Warren Buffett looked at Jeff Bezos and just said, yeah, I knew he was a smart guy, but how would I have known he would be the guy that would win this battle? Now that we know it, why not go invest in Amazon? And that's because of the final M, which is margin of safety. Now, this is the part where the FAANG stocks are going to come under serious scrutiny. In order to believe that a FAANG stock is priced at least 50% below its true value, you better have a really clear expectation about where these companies are going to be in the next 10 years or so. For most people, except maybe the most seriously optimistic people, FAANG stocks are really highly priced right now. It would be very hard to buy most of them and say, yeah, I know for sure I'm getting a deal. Given that FAANG stocks exhibit most of the qualities of a wonderful company, except maybe for their price, they're certainly stocks worth watching. And you don't want to say the thing isn't on sale just because it's a highly purchased stock around the internet. You want to be able to look at it independently of what other people are saying, which is one of the most amazing things about Buffett's investment in Apple recently. I mean, he bought the heck out of that company in spite of it being up near the highest prices it's ever sold for. So here's a good question for you. I'd like to hear from you guys. Do you want to wait until these stocks go on sale? Do you think the FAANGs are overpriced? Do you think they're only going to go up from here? Now, this should be really interesting commentary on this one. So leave a comment below with your answer, and I'll be sure and follow up with you. And thanks for watching. Now go play with one of your FAANG stocks. Hey, if you enjoyed this video and you feel it was valuable for teaching you more about FAANG stocks, hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. And if you want more investing content, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift. Thanks for watching, you guys.